According to a survey done by Community Foundation Silicon Valley and Hispanic Foundation of Silicon Valley, the majority of Hispanics don't see themselves as donors or philanthropists. The same survey, however, showed that Latinos in Silicon Valley give on average 3.9% of their annual household income to charity, on par with Caucasians at 3.8% and double that of Asians at 1.8%. There's a foundation working to increase Latino participation in philanthropy in Arizona. Joining me to talk about some of their initiatives is Tony Vanegas, philanthropic advisor for the Arizona Community Foundation. Tony is also honorary consul of Honduras in Arizona. Also here is Belen Gonzalez, program officer for the Nina Mason Pulliam Charitable Trust and chair of the Latina Giving Circle. Tony, Belen, welcome to Horizonte. Tony, let's start with just a little bit of background about the Arizona Community Foundation, then we're going to talk about some of these other initiatives.
Sure. If I may go back, you know, I studied philosophy back in Honduras a long time ago, and I remember a lecture from the professor that said that Socrates said 2,500 years ago that any idea that starts in somebody else's mind. And that's how the Community Foundation started, back in 1914 in Cleveland, Ohio. Mr. Frederick Goff, a banker, you know, a mayor of Cleveland, came up with this idea of having the elite contribute to this fund, what he called the community chest, to help those in the community. Next year, something happened in Chicago, and the Chicago Community Trust was established by another banker. And then moved to 1978. Our own Bert Goetz, you know, from Chicago, moved to Phoenix, brought the idea over to Phoenix and engaged some other leaders in the community, Sir Richard Whitney and Miss Betty and Newt Rosenzweig, and they started the Arizona Community Foundation using the same principles back 1914, you know, to pool our funds to help our community.
And it's grown incredibly since then. I think we were talking to offset some of the figures, and we're in the $36, $37 million a year.
That's just a number of grants that we have given. We are already over $500 million in assets. We have invested over $400 million since 1978. We have given over $5 million in scholarships. We have over 100 scholarship funds. And one thing that makes us unique, I think, in the Community Foundation is that we have an affiliate system throughout the state. So we have 11 affiliates that work with local community leaders to not only raise funds, but also distribute funds in their community.
And now we've got an effort that's targeted at Hispanics. It's not the first one, though. Tell us a little bit about Hispanics and Philanthropy, which kicked off a few years ago.
Yes, and you're very familiar with this, I said, because you were very supportive back in 2005. You know, there was a study done by Hispanics in Philanthropy out of San Francisco that a small percentage of funding went to support Latino-led nonprofits. So they came up with a project where if we raise local funding, they would be able to match it one-to-one. So we, Community Foundation, took the leadership role at that time, put in $100,000, engaged other foundations here in Phoenix in the private sector, and also individual donors. We had about 25 donors who contributed anywhere from $50,000 to $25,000. And we raised $420,000, which meant we could get the match. And then we worked and selected 10 nonprofits throughout the state. And we worked with them for 3 years to help them be more effective in fundraising, fund development, board development, and technology. And that was very successful.
So this is kind of the next phase. We've got Latinos Unidos and the Latina Giving Circle, and I want to talk about both of them. But before we do that, a little bit about the survey that we talked about in the introduction that was done in Silicon Valley. I assume part of what they were dealing with is the sense that Latinos are not as charitable as other ethnic groups, but that proved to not to be the case. It's different, perhaps, but as generous as any other group.
Exactly. That dispelled the myth that, you know, that you've heard that Latinos are takers. Well, it's not true. You know, we give. We've been giving for thousands of years, and we give. We may not be familiar with the strategic philanthropy endowments, but we give. So the studies show that we gave even on par with Caucasian even more. So we're trying to build on that values that we have as Latinos, you know, taking care of our own community, and we think this is the right time now to move on, given the infrastructure that we have in place and the upward mobility that we have as Latinos to engage Latinos in strategic philanthropy. So that's what my colleague Belen and I are trying to do at the Community Foundation.
And Belen, let's talk about one initiative that you're very involved in, that's the Latina Giving Circle.
Right.
Give us the history of that.
Sure. So the Latina Giving Circle started in 2009 and is essentially a fund of the Arizona Community Foundation. What we seek to do is raise donations from Latinas, Latinos, non-Latinos, contributions of $1,000 annually, and then collectively we decide how to disperse those funds in the areas of immigration, education, healthcare, and leadership. To date, we've raised a little bit over $80,000, some from individual donors, some from matching funds from the Arizona Community Foundation, and we've awarded 3 grants in the 3 years that we've been in existence.
And the ultimate goal is what?
Our mission is to provide our time, talent, and treasures to support Arizona's communities. Our ultimate vision is to establish a multi-million dollar endowed fund that will support Arizona's communities, particularly Latino communities, indefinitely.
And so your target audience, both in terms of participants and potential recipients, Latino community, but as I understand, it's open to anybody who wants to participate.
That is correct.
And information, people can get that by going to the Community Foundation website.
Right. Our website is azlatinagivingcircle.org, and you can find more information about our focus areas and more information on how to become a member through the website.
Now, Tony, going back to that survey, what it showed was that Latinos give, but they give in different ways. They give to family and church and so forth, and they're not as accustomed to giving to nonprofits or through something like the Arizona Community Foundation. So what are you doing to make people aware of these opportunities and the additional leverage that something like the Community Foundation can provide?
Right. Part of our goal is, again, to build on this strength that we have as a culture of givers. You know, we know we give. You know, when there's a fire, you know, there's an earthquake, you know we give. So part of our strategy with the Latinos Unidos is to provide forums in the upcoming month to provide information. We have a few Latinos, but we have a few Latinos who are state planning attorneys. So we'll be doing in both in English and Spanish to talk about the, what we call the Community Foundation, the power of endowment. You know, we have hundreds of examples, you know, where we show that the power of endowment, you collect and pulling resources, you know, you put it, invest it, and then you use the earnings to support whatever you want to support. So part of our strategy will be to provide education to our community about strategic philanthropy, and we'll be doing that throughout the year at different events.
Now, you kicked this off about a year ago, right?
About a year ago.
And give us a sense for the kinds of people who are already involved.
We have quite a few. We have leaders in the community. I'm working with about 8 well-known community leaders from different backgrounds. We have individuals. We're talking to corporations too. Again, what I said earlier.
People like Al Molina, who's very generous with his time.
Of course. Al Molina, well. Alberto Rios, you know, Barbara Rodriguez Mandel, Aaron Belen Gonzalez, you know, Ken Paredes Scrivener. So I'm surrounding myself with a group of leaders in the community who are working with me and putting together our brains to come up with ideas and activities to engage Latinos in strategic philanthropy. And we think we at the Community Foundation have a perfect place. We've been doing it for 34 years. We've been very successful in engaging not only here in Phoenix, but throughout the state, which I think makes us very unique.
Belen, talk a little bit more about donor-advised funds, because I think that's a new concept for many people.
That is a new concept. So what Arizona Community Foundation and many community foundations across the country are able to do is offer individuals who are interested in giving in a certain subject area or to certain populations, they can channel those funds through their local community foundation. The local community foundation can help that individual or that family decide how to disperse those funds to achieve a certain impact, perhaps in education or early childhood care or literacy, whatever it may be.
So instead of going out and starting your own nonprofit and incurring all the costs and involved in that and then the fundraising efforts, it's a way to use the existing structure of the Community Foundation and to have some impact.
Correct.
So why is this important for the Hispanic community in particular?
Because this is a new concept for the Latino community. And as our buying power increases, as we become, as a community, we achieve more college degrees, as we enter professional careers in greater numbers, our wealth will start to accumulate. And the question I have is, how will the Latino community invest their dollars, their charitable dollars? And to let the Latino community know there are other venues to disperse their funds and to really think strategically about, if they're passionate about education, then how can they use their dollars to move education in the right direction?
Tony, the goals for Latinos Unidos are pretty ambitious.
Well, yes, they are, but we're confident we can reach that goal. Our goal is to reach about $1 million by 2015. We already have 120,000, so we are on the right track. And like Belen said, we have a great opportunity to build on what Latinos are doing as a community. We are moving up, and you look at every category, politics, education, elected official. We are acquiring wealth, and we want to be active and help our community. So if we build on those values that we have as a culture, we're confident we can reach our goal.
Is your job any tougher because you're in Arizona, which has been ground zero for the immigration debate?
Not really. We, as a foundation, we did very well last year. We are on target, even may exceed our goal for this coming year. So there's still a lot of good people out there who want to do good. And we're trying to build on that. And if we just need to show them what we're doing and what we can do when we pool our resources. It's easier for us to, if we need to raise $100, it's easier if we all put in $25 than if you put $100. So again, using that strategy and the resources that we have in the Community Foundation to support the Latinos throughout the state.
Tony, we're almost out of time. I want to end with a discussion about a big event you got coming up to kind of be the official kickoff for Latinos Unidos.
We do. We're doing on December 11th. The first of what we hope will become an annual event at the Community Foundation. We're going to honor two of our Latinos who have been doing work to support Latino philanthropy. Alfredo Molina, you mentioned, and our own Belen Gonzalez. They've been working for a few years to support Latino philanthropy. So we're having a nice event at the Community Foundation. Food, music, and just to honor you, celebrate. We like to have parties. I mean, we parties when some baby's born, we have a quinceañera, we just need an excuse. So this is a good excuse for us to honor, recognize our Latinos. And we hope this will become an annual event. And we hope to do it in the Hispanic Heritage Month, which falls between September 15th and October 15th. So if anybody's interested, they can contact me at the foundation, and we hope to have you there.
It's a great excuse, Belen. Congratulations.
Thank you, Belen,
and you, Tony, for joining us on Horizonte to talk about these great efforts. Much appreciated.
Thank you.